Gut bacteria. About how many days do you think it takes to be in an ICU in a hospital to go from 40 strains of gut bacteria down to maybe 4, 3, 2, possibly even 1? And the bacteria that's left after 30 days in a hospital that's in your gut are not the good ones. In an article titled Critically Ill, ICU patients lose almost all the gut microbes and the ones left aren't good. This published in the online app Open Access Journal of the American Society for Microbiology, this 2014. Researchers kept on looking at, looking at why patients kept on dying of sepsis. In other words, they kept dying of sepsis and not their ailments, and they wanted to find out exactly why. So they grabbed the hypothesis about looking at their bacteria in their gut, or the gut microbes. And what they found out is the constant administration of antibiotics to keep normally infection rates down in hospitals actually had a reverse effect in some cases, forming or causing sepsis. And they discovered through 30 days of ICU that basically normally, healthy volunteers who have 40 different strains of gut microbes at least, after 30 days of ICU, we're down to 1 to 4. Even more intriguing, the gut microbes remaining aren't even friendly ones. For example, a few of the patients, the only microbes they had remaining were different strains of Candida. Now, here's what gets real intriguing. Now, the researchers said, all right, let's do this. Let's take the bacteria from basically fecal matter of these ICU patients that have been over there for 30 days. Let's feed it to some worms as a test group, obviously. Who else is going to eat bacteria from fecal matter? All right, so normally with the worms, they give them yeast and bacteria and they tend to be fine. But when they would feed the worms, as their animal test subjects, the bacteria from patients in the ICU, it would kill them. Even worse and more intriguing, with the remaining bacteria remaining, 1 to 4, whatever comes down to Candida, when they gave them opiates, it even made it worse because it confused the signals where bacteria couldn't communicate properly, so it may cause your immune system to go haywire or crash it or whatever. But bottom line is all these gut microbes, which are your defense against sepsis, were generally gone. Now, albeit this was a small study, they need to do more research to basically confirm or deny the results. But however, if you want to cover your bet, now the researchers here, they recommend to maintain a high phosphate levels in the gut to be beneficial for the bacteria. Otherwise, if possible, it may not be a bad idea if you get an opportunity to hedge your bets with some positive probiotics with a good variety in that mixture. So keep in mind, 30 days in a hospital or longer, sepsis becomes a problem. Look at that gut. Published online open access journal, the American Society for Microbiology, this September 2014. Thanks once again.